Hello everyone, welcome to Math Cyberspace. This is Dipendu Gonai and today I am going to start the lecture 5 of Calculus of Variation, and today's topic is Rayleigh-Ridge method. Till now we have learned the Euler-Lagrange equation, various types of Euler-Lagrange equation, the meaningless variational problem, isoperimetric problem. Now today is our topic, Rayleigh-Ridge method. But before starting my lecture, I will request you, if you like my content, then please share with your friends and subscribe our channel. Now, what is Rayleigh-Ridge method? In calculus of variation, we have some functional like Iy equals to integration a to b f of x y y dash and dx, and there are some boundary conditions like y a and y b equals to y b. These are our boundary conditions. Similarly, there are some boundary conditions, that is boundary value problem in ODE. In ordinary differential equation, there are some boundary value problem. Now the question is, can we solve that boundary value problem of ordinary differential equation using the concept of calculus of variation? Suppose we have a boundary value problem like AY double dashed plus BY dashed plus CY equals to, let's some function fx, where a, b, c are maybe some constant, maybe some function of x. Okay. Now the question is, can we okay, there are some boundary conditions. Suppose same boundary conditions, ya equals to ya and yb equals to yb. Now the question is, can we solve this ordinary differential equation using the concept of calculus of variation? Because here also boundary conditions given, here also boundary conditions given, both are boundary value problem. Here is the Rayleigh-Ridge method is important for this case. In general, you can say that Rayleigh-Ridge method is a bridge between the problem of ordinary differential equation and calculus of variation. Okay. If anyhow we can change this boundary value problem into a functional, this is our functional Iy equals to integration a to b f of x y y dash. If anyhow we can change this ordinary differential equation into a functional, in that case we can solve this problem using COV. And here is the Rayleigh-Ridge method. This is the main fact of Rayleigh-Ridge method. Okay. Suppose we have a boundary value problem. This is ax y double dashed plus bx y dashed plus cx y equals to fx, where a, b and c are functions of x, and two boundary conditions are given, yx1 equals to y1 and yx2 equals to y2. Now the condition is, first condition is, we have to change this ordinary differential equation into a functional. Okay, so first step is, we have to construct a functional. This is our step one. Now how we can construct this functional? Suppose this is our functional I y x equals to integration x1 to x2 p x y dash square plus q x y square plus r x y dx. Now what is p q r? P equals to e to the power integration b by a dx. A b are, a is coefficient function of y double dash, b is coefficient function of y dash, and q is equals to minus c by a px, r is equals to 2 fx by a px. Now you will ask me how we are getting this value of pqr. Here is the calculation. This is our given ordinary differential equation, which I indicate by equation number one. if we multiply this equation number one, if we multiply both side by mu x, mu is any arbitrary function of x, we are multiplying this equation number one by mu x, then this is the form a mu y double dashed plus b mu y plus c mu y equals to f mu, where mu is also function of x and a, b, c, f are all function of x. Now we are substituting. Actually, we have to get this functional. Okay, we have to get this functional. So we are substituting a mu equals to minus 2 mu, b mu equals to, sorry, a mu equals to minus 2p, b mu equals to minus 2p dashed, c mu equals to 2q, and f mu equals to minus r. Now divide 2 by 1. If we divide 2 by 1, then p dashed by p equals to b by a. Now simplify this, then you will get p equals to e to the power integration b by a dx. This is our p equals to e to the power integration b by a dx. Now from equation number one, we can get the value of mu. Mu equals to minus 2p by a. Mu equals to minus 2p by a. So what will be q? Q equals to, from equation number three, c mu by 2. Now put this value of mu in here. So we are getting q equals to minus ca by p. Okay. Now from four, we are getting r is equals to minus f mu. Now put the value of mu. So we are getting mu equals to minus 2p by a. So 2f by a into p. This is 2fx by a into p. So in this process, we are getting the values of p, q, and r. Okay. So we already get the functional, that is I, y, x. Now here, see that the name of the topic is approximate solution of boundary value problem. We know what is boundary value problem. Now, why is the term approximate solution? For this, here we get the functional I, y, x, but we don't know what is y, x. Now, to find out y, x, we have to approximately choose the y, x function. Suppose we are approximating y, x using a polynomial expression. Suppose yx equals to sigma I equals to 0 to n c I y I x. I is from 0 to n. But we cannot choose any yi, or we cannot choose any ci. There are some conditions. The conditions are, number one, ci must be constant. Okay. And we have to find out the values of ci. And number two, this yi should be continuous, and not only continuous, yi belongs to C2. That is, yi should be continuously differentiable up to second order. Okay, yi should be continuously differentiable up to second order. Now, condition three is y0. y0 satisfies the boundary conditions, and all other y's, yi vanish on boundary conditions. That means if we expand this will of the form yx equals to c0 y0 plus c1 y1 plus c2 y2 and so on plus cn yn. Now the condition three says that this y0 will satisfy our boundary condition. What is our boundary condition? This is our boundary condition, yx1 equals to y1 and yx2 equals to y2. So this says that y0 will satisfy the boundary condition yx1 equals to y1 and yx2 equals to y2. But here given, other yi vanish on boundary condition, boundary points. That means yx1 equals to 0, yx2 equals to 0. This is the boundary condition for other yi. That means y1, x1 equals to 0, y1 x2 equals to 0, and similarly for all other yi. Okay, and fourth condition is yi should be linearly independent. This is very very important. Okay, yi should be linearly independent. So this is our conditions for choosing the approximation or approx yx. Now we already get I, we get y. Now what is our main task? We get y. Now this yx, we have to put this yx in equation number 3, that is iy. If we put the value of y in equation number 3, then we will get the iyx. Yx equals to sigma I equals to 0 to n c0 yix. This is our yx we put on equation number 3, that is our functional. When we put this yx, after integrating or after calculating, we will get that the resulting i will be a function of c1, c2, c3, cn. That is, the resulting I will be function of only those constants. Now we have to find out the extrema. It is the main aim of calculus of variation. Now to find out the extrema, the condition is del I del C I equals to zero. So we will get n equations. That is del I del C1 equals to zero, del I del C2 equals to 0, and so on, del I del Cn equals to 0. Now when we solve these simultaneous equations, we will get the values of C1, C2, C3 up to Cn. When we get the values of C1, C2, C3, Cn, after that we will put the values of Ci in this approximation. That is yx equals to yi, and y is our extremal. So we get the extremal. And this is the Rayleigh-Ridge method. We will understand this Rayleigh-Ridge method with an example. Here given, solve the boundary value problem by RR method. That is Rayleigh-Ridge method. Okay. And the boundary value problem is y double dashed minus y plus x equals to 0, and two boundary conditions are given, y 0 equals to 0 and y 1 equals to 0. We have to solve this boundary value problem using Rayleigh-Ridge method. In Rayleigh-Ridge method, what is our first step? Our first step is we have to find out the extremal. Okay, this is our step one. So iy equals to integration x0 to x1 pxy dashed square plus qxy square plus rxy. This is our step one. Now what is p? P is equals to e to the power b by a dx, q equals to, and so on. Okay, now compare this given differential equation with our general differential equation. So we are getting a is equals to 1, coefficient of y double dashed is a, and here coefficient of y double dashed is 1. So a is equals to 1. There is no term of y dashed, so b is equals to 0. Okay, and coefficient of y is minus 1. Here c, so c is equals to minus 1. And here fx in general form, sorry, this will be fx. In general form, fx is in the right side. So if we take x in right side, it will be minus x. So fx equals to minus x. Okay, now what is p? P is equals to px equals to e to the power integration b by a dx. Now b is equals to 0, so e to the power 0 equals to 1. So p is equals to 1. Okay, now what is q? Q is equals to minus c by a px, minus c by a px, and c is equals to minus 1. So here minus 1 and minus 1, this will be plus 1, and a is equals to plus 1, and we already get p is equals to 1. So q is equals to 1. And similarly, we can calculate r is equals to minus 2x, because fx equals to minus x. So this will be minus 2x, a is equals to 1, and px is equals to 1. So minus 2x. Now, so the functional is Iyx equals to, the boundary points are 0, 1, 0 and 1. So integration 0 to 1. Px y dash t square. This is our functional, px y dash t square. What is p? P equals to 1. So this will be y dash square plus qx y square. What is q? Q equals to 1. So this will be plus y square plus rx y. What is r? R equals to minus 2x. So this will be minus 2xy. So this is our functional. This is our functional. So we already get functional. Now, what is our second step? Second step is, when you get the functional, we have to approximately choose yx. Okay. Now we are choosing. This is our yx. Yx equals to c0 plus c1x plus c2x square. Now, why we choose this form? There are some conditions for choosing yx. The conditions are ci must be constant, okay, and yi must be continuous, linearly independent. That's why we choose a polynomial function. A polynomial function is always continuous, and this always belongs to c2, that is continuously differentiable up to second order. The one more condition is that this yx will satisfy the boundary conditions. So y0 equals to 0, this implies c0 equals to 0, and y1 equals to 0, this implies c1 plus c2 equals to 0, that is c2 equals to minus c1. So what is our yx? Yx equals to c1x into 1 minus x. This is our yx, and we name it as equation number 2. Now, step 3 is, we have to put this yx into our functional. Let me show you. This is our step 2 yx, and step 3 is, we have to put, step 3 is calculate the functional yx, put the value of yx 4 on 3. Okay, so this is our step 3. We have to put this yx into our this functional. This is our functional, equation number 1. So we will put now. The functional is y dash t square. The functional is y dash square plus y square minus 2xy. So here yx equals to c1x into 1 minus x. This is our y dash square plus y minus, what was that? Plus y square minus 2xy. This is our plus y square. This is our minus 2xy. Okay. Now you can calculate this. After calculating this, you will get Iy equals to, this is the form, 11 by 30 C1 square minus 1 by 6 C1. Okay. Here we are completing step 3. Now our main task is, next task is, we have to calculate the value of this constant. I already have told you that the resulting Iy will be a function of only constant. Here I is only a function of C1. Now we have to find out the value of C1. For this, the condition of extremal is del I del C1 equals to 0. If we calculate this, then we are getting C1 equals to 5 by 12. Now put the value of C1 in this equation number 2. So yx equals to c1 equals to 5 by 12, 5 by, sorry, 5 by 22, 5 by 22 x into 1 minus x. This is our required yx. And this is our Rayleigh-Ridge method. Okay. Now we will solve some previous year example of CSIR NET exam. This is our first question. This question has been asked in CSIR NET exam June 2012, and this is a part C problem, that is 4.75 marks. The question is, an approximate solution z equals to z0 xy to the problem of extremizing the functional, and this is our functional given, And where D, this is our region D, D is the square minus 1 less than equals to X less than equals to 1 minus 1 less than equals to Y less than equals to 1. That means it is a unit square. Unit square, okay. What is unit square? Unit square means X square plus, this will be our unit square, that is X square plus Y square equals to 1, okay. And z equals to 0 on the boundary of the square is of the form, there are four options given. Option A is z0 equals to sigma I equals to 1 to n alpha I phi I xy, where alpha I are constants. This is obviously true from our conditions. Ci must be constant, so alpha I constants, this is true. And functions phi I are linearly independent in D. We have learned that yi must be linearly independent. Here this is phi I, so option one is correct. Okay, now option two, z0 equals to alpha 1 phi 1 xy plus alpha 2 phi 2 xy, where alpha 1 and alpha 2 are constants. This is true. And phi 1 phi 2 have continuous partial derivatives. This is also true. We have I have told you that the yi must be continuously differentiable. Okay, so option B is also true. Now option three is z0 equals to alpha phi of xy, where alpha is a constant and phi is continuous. This is also true. So option C is correct. Now option D is z0 equals to x square minus 1 into y square minus 1 by 16. We have to calculate this. First of all, we will check this z0 is satisfying our boundary conditions or not. What is our boundary conditions? The boundary is D. D is a square minus 1 less than equals to X less than equals to 1 and minus 1 less than equals to Y less than equals to 1. Okay, that means Z equals to 0 on, and Z equals to 0, that means Z equals to 0 on this region. Okay, this is our boundary condition. So we put X equals to 1, so this will getting, I will get 0. And if we put x y equals to 1, so you get this will 0. So boundary conditions are satisfying. So we have to check now. Now the step 3 is, sorry, step 2 is we have to approximately choose yx. So same here, we have to approximately choose z. So we are choosing z equals to c x square minus 1 and y square minus 1. Now see, this z is satisfying all our conditions of Rayleigh-Ridge method. This is, here c is constant. These are satisfying our boundary conditions. Put x equals to 1, x equals to minus 1. Put y equals to 1, y equals to minus 1. You will get z equals to 0. So satisfying the boundary conditions. Also, this is belongs to C2, that is continuously differentiable up to second order. So these conditions are also satisfying. So this approximation is correct. Okay. Now here functional is del z del x plus del z del y tar whole square. Okay. So what is del z del x? Del z del x equals to 2cx into y square minus 1. Del z del y equals to 2cy into x square minus 1. Now put this value of zx, zy and z in this functional, given functional. Okay, if we put this, you can calculate this easily. We are reaching on this step. Okay, from here this x square plus y square, we are getting x square plus y square in each term. Okay, and we know that this is a unit square, so x square plus y square equals to 1. Put x square plus y square equals to 1. After that, you will get this one, minus 4c x square x square y square plus 4c square minus 2c x square y square. After simplifying this, we are getting this form. Okay, and first of all, we are integrating with respect to y. With respect to y, we are getting this form. You can calculate this portion. And finally, we are getting I, f is equals to 128 by 9 c square minus 8 c by 9. This is our f, that is, this is our functional, resulting functional, which is a function of only constant term c. Now we have to find out the value of c. For this we know the condition del c, sorry, del f del c equals to zero. Okay, this is our condition to find the extrema. So del f del c equals to zero, we are getting c equals to 1/32. Now put the value of c in this, in this yx. This is our z c, c into x square minus 1 into y square minus 1, and we get c equals to what, 1/32. So what is z? Z equals to x square minus 1 into y square minus 1 by 32. But here given z0 equals to by 16. So this is incorrect. So only a, b and c are correct. Okay, now the next question. Next question is, in the reach method, seeking an extremal of the functional, the functional is given iy equals to x0 to x1, f of x y y dash dy dx, and boundary conditions are yx0 equals to a, yx1 equals to b. The coordinate function or the admissible function. Now what is coordinate function? We have chosen yx equals to sigma I equals to 1 to n c I y I x. This yi are called coordinate function, okay, or admissible function. Okay, admissible function. So this is our admissible function here, phi I x. Now the question is, options are, option A, phi I must be linearly independent. This is obviously true. Option B is continuous. This is true. Option C is smooth. This is also true because continuously differentiable. And option D is linearly independent. Obviously linearly independent, smooth, also true. And the functional be considered not along admissible curve y equals to yx, but only along all possible linear combinations of admissible functions. Obviously this is true because we considered yx equals to ci yix, that is yx depending on all yi. Okay, so option D is also true. So in this problem, all options are correct, and this is a 4.75 marks. This question has been asked in June 2011. Okay, this is for today. If you like my content, then please share with your friends and subscribe our channel and stay with us. Thank you.